I'm going to explain to you guys the exact steps you need to take to get your very first wholesale deal. If I had to start over from zero, this is exactly what I would do to get started wholesaling deals so I could rebuild my business. Step number one is we need to generate leads. This means we need to find people who are showing signs that they may need to sell their property soon. We're looking for people who are in pre-foreclosure, people who are late on their taxes, people who have liens on their property, people who have recently inherited their property, and more. Finding people who meet these criteria is extremely easy nowadays. There are plenty of different tools that can help you find these people, but the tool I would use is called Batch Leads. Batch Leads is a website where you can pull data for people that are in those exact situations and more. You can click the link in the description for a 7-day free trial of Batch Leads, and I made an entire video showing you exactly how I pull leads, and you can see that right here. Step number two is to reach out to the people on these lists and see if they want to sell. Now, the way I would reach out to them is with a cold call. In order for me to cold call them, I'm going to need their phone number. We get their phone number by doing what's called a skip trace. Skip tracing connects phone numbers with names and addresses. Now, there are plenty of different websites that offer skip tracing services, but I prefer to skip trace right there in Batch Leads. Once you've pulled your list of motivated homeowners and skip traced it, it is now time to move on to step number three, which is to cold call each of the homeowners. You're going to call them up and ask if they would be interested in selling their property. People way overcomplicate this part when it's actually super easy. Ask them if they want to sell. If they say yes, get some basic information about the property. Have they updated it all? Who's living there? Does it need any repairs? When do they want to sell? How much do they want to sell it for? And why are they looking to sell? Basically, the goal here is to have a conversation with them that's going to allow you to understand their situation and the property itself so that you can make an offer. That leads us to step number four, which is for you to make them an offer. After you've had a conversation with them and determined that they do want to sell, thank them for their time and let them know you'll be calling them back shortly with an offer. After you hang up the phone, you need to go on Zillow to determine the property's ARV, which stands for after repair value. This means what the house will be worth after it's been fully renovated. You will determine the property's ARV by looking at what houses in the neighborhood that are of similar size have sold for in the last year. Now you will need to determine a repair estimate. You can estimate the repairs by using these simple formulas. If the property only needs a light remodel, meaning just new paint and flooring, multiply the property's square footage by 12. If the property needs a full remodel on the inside, multiply the property's square footage by 35. If the property needs a full remodel on the inside, plus needs some work on the outside, like new landscaping, new roof, new AC, multiply the square footage by 45. If the property is a full gut, meaning everything needs to be replaced, including the major mechanicals like the electricity and the plumbing, multiply the square footage by 65. Once you have the ARV and a repair estimate, there's a very simple formula for determining your MAO, which stands for max allowable offer. This number is the most amount you can pay for the property in order to wholesale it. To get your MAO, you multiply the ARV by 70% and then you subtract out your repair costs. Depending on the market, this number will allow you to wholesale the property and make anywhere between $10,000 and $30,000 as an assignment fee. Once you have your MAO, step number five is to make your offer. The way you're going to want to do this is to call them back and make your initial offer. Your initial offer should always be $10,000 or $20,000 less than what your MAO is so that you have some room to negotiate. Once you've agreed to a price that is equal to or hopefully even less than your MAO, it's time to send them a contract. You can download the exact contract I use to wholesale properties all across the United States at www.freewholesalingresources.com. That link will also be in the description below. Once you've gotten the contract signed, it's time to move on to step number six, which is to get that contract sold to somebody else. The way you're going to do this is by sending the deal to local real estate investors. You can find real estate investors in Facebook groups. Just search on Facebook for Real Estate Investors In and then the name of the city where your deal is. Reach out to these investors and let them know you are looking to sell a deeply discounted off-market deal. After you found an investor that's interested, you're going to send them an assignment of contract, which allows you to actually sell your original agreement with the seller to them. The last step, step number seven, is to get paid. You do this by sending both the purchase agreement and the assignment agreement to the title company. Then at the close of escrow, the buyer is going to give the title company the money. The title company will give the seller their money, and they will give you your entire assignment fee. Now, all that's left is for you to rinse and repeat. This is the exact process I have followed that has made me over $1 million a year for the past couple of years. Now, if you feel like you need a little bit more help and you'd like some guidance from me, I recommend looking into my new program, Wholesaling 101. Wholesaling 101 is a program I have designed to help people learn how to wholesale real estate. It includes step-by-step tutorials on every single part of the process, from finding the leads to making offers, negotiating techniques, guides on how to calculate ARV and your MAO, in-depth walkthroughs of how title companies work, and full explanations on all the contracts. In addition to that, I also meet once a week with all my Wholesaling 101 students to answer questions, give them additional help, and make sure they're on the right track. If you're interested in learning more about Wholesaling 101, click the link down below. If you have found this video to be helpful, please give it a like and hit the subscribe button. Now, if you have any further questions, ask me in the comments. I'd love to help. As always, thank you for watching, and we will see you on the next one.